Nice set of wheels, eh? For some people, their identity is all tied up in what they have. Their identity is tied up in the work that they do, the house that they own, or the vehicle that they drive. For us as Christ followers, our identity comes from Jesus. We've been learning about humility and what that means for us. Jesus demonstrated ultimate humility when he gave his life for us when he died on the cross. He didn't deserve to do that, but he knew that without him, we deserved death. Jesus showed us humility by giving up what was rightfully his so that we might live. Some of the choices that we make in the way we live is all about us. It's all about us being first. If you wonder whether that's true of you, have a listen to the things that you say or the speed that you drive down the motorway. See if you want to be cutting in front of somebody else who's driving that little bit slower. What about in the shopping mall when you're ready to go through the checkout and something happens and the person before you takes far too long and you look down at other queues and you find out that others have got out ahead of you? How often does that tick you off? That really shows us that we are so driven to be first. We want to be ahead of others. Well, in humility, we need to consider others as important as what we are. We need to make that a right choice. We need to make that decision ahead of time that we're not going to be wanting to be first all the time. Now, here's where it happens at home. As parents, we often want to be first when it comes to an argument. We want to win. Sometimes we forget about what we've even argued about because it's more important winning. Humility is about being able to say, okay, I will put somebody else first. When Jesus died on the cross, he said these very important words. He said, "It is finished." What he was referring to, of course, was the mission that he was on. Salvation was complete. It was now available for all of us. I wonder this week whether we have to say to ourselves, personally, "It is finished." The desire for us to be first in everything. Let's take a real attitude check this week as we look at the things that we do, listen to the words that we say to each other, and see if we can hear humility words coming out of our mouths. Let's see if we can see humility demonstrated just in the everyday rhythm of what we do. First of all in our homes, but beyond there. Let's make humility count in the grocery store, when we're driving our cars. Whenever we're dealing with anybody, let's be people of humility. Let's show others how important they are by putting them first. Humility takes practice. So this week, it's practice week for us. We want to see humility in place in our homes. So keep an eye out on yourself, but also look for others and see if you can see humility in action. Those moments when you see that someone else in your home has put others first. It'll be a great conversation around the table to how you're getting on with putting this into practice. It's not easy, it's a challenge, but I'm sure you're up to the challenge. Why not even celebrate those moments when humility has been in action? Don't make it all about you, make it all about the influence that you have in your world. So take this Easter time to practice humility and to recognize the ultimate humility that Jesus showed when he gave his life for you and for me.